Welcome to Prefabricated Structures. Today's video is related to design of pre-stressed concrete planks and joists for roofing and flooring. Materials are concrete and reinforcement as earlier we have seen. This is the shapes, dimensions and tolerances. So precast reinforced concrete planks, shape of a planks shall be a rectangular with a haunches as shown in the figure. Top surface shall be checkered with a finished. So this is the checkered part with a finished. We can see the total length and total breadth, wherein the above haunched and checkered part is in this way. So in an isometric view, we are able to see in this particular format, and in the particular part of sectional XX from here to here, we are able to see in this part, and at section YY, we are able to see the particular reinforcement is in this particular way. So how the reinforcement is provided? This is the roof covering, we can say, for the slabs which we can provide, wherein the interlocking system is provided here, which is again placed with the concrete. So this is one of the precast concrete planks which can be used as the roofing materials. So this is as per the IS 14142. So as per this, whatever the dimensions are there, these dimensions are mandatory to maintain the things. Then coming the squareness, the long edge of a plank shall be taken as the baseline. The shorter side shall not vary in its length from perpendicular distance between long edges by more than 3 mm. Flatness, the maximum deviation from 1.5 meter straight edge placed in any position on a nominal plane surface shall not exceed 2 mm. So the dimension deviation should not be varying more than 2 mm. If it varies more than 2 mm, the whole structures can be going to change the whole dimensions. So that much minute amount of corrections or flatness should be provided. So this is the regarding 2 mm. Design, the planks are shall be designed as a simply supported for a self weight including in situ concrete. So their self weight will be coming, and then when they are placing, we are providing a in situ concrete such that the both can get joined into the concrete part over a haunches, and as a continuous slab for a hold comprising live load, self weight and dead load of a floor finish or waterproofing treatment even, because both are joined in this way, so we can have a seepage between the two particular planks, so that we have to avoid for that particular section. The design shall be in accordance with the limit state method of the IS 456 only. So as per the simply supported slab, how we consider a design, so this single plank can be designed. So this is the particular formwork for the section of preparing the reinforced planks, that is the particular planks which we have seen. So we can see this is of a wooden material. The wooden material is provided in this way, wherein the concrete and reinforcements are placed and the haunching system will be easily coming. So this is the interlocking system here in between, which we can easily see, and this is the haunch part which is coming in the detailed section. So we can see how much section of the wooden sections are provided and how this particular. So this section is provided for the particular section at the edges. We can see at a QQ section, means this is the particular edge of this particular part of section. Then this is the beading part, the edges part, which is supported in this way section, this particular part, which is in this manner. And the edges which are here, this is the particular support at this particular part where the haunch is going to come and rest. So the haunch value is this part which is going to come and rest here. So this is the interlocking system at this particular edges. The section which is provided here, this is the particular part. The hinge is here. Hinge means it will be rotating in this direction, and we are able to easily open that part in that manner. So concreting is done here up to, then we will put the concreting inside here, then it is hardened, then we are easily removing from edges end to end, and this as a upper part. So this is the formwork. Now the reinforcement for a plank shall comprise of a 3 equal spaced bars of a required diameter along the length of the planks as a main reinforcement. So as the length is there, the reinforcement is provided. Distribution reinforcement shall be equal to more than the minimum number recommended as per the IS 456. The main reinforcement shall also fulfill the requirement of maximum permissible spacing is given. So usually reinforcement for planks of a roofs and a floors residential building for a spacing of a joist at a 1.5 meter shall comprise of 3 bars of 6 mm diameter steel grade conforming IS 432 as a main reinforcement and 6 mm diameter of a mild steel grade at a 200 mm center to center can be easily provided. In the absence of detailed design, same reinforcement may be used for a spacing of a joist smaller than 1.5 meters. So reinforcement for RCC joist shall be provided as per the required design. So if a span is more, the design can be changed, but the minimum part of reinforcements is 3 bars of 6 mm diameter and 6 mm diameter as the reinforcement for the distribution bar, and we have to provide it at a spacing of 200 mm center to center. Casting and curing of a precast elements. Precast elements are cast molds. Molds may be generally made well of a seasoned wood, good quality timber or an equivalent wood. So as we have seen this particular, the wooden part of mold. Then it can be also for a mass production easily. Steel can be used, plastic can be used or FRP molds can be used with an advantage. Any material used for a making of a mold shall be rigid, non-absorbent and non-corrodable and shall be maintaining the dimensions with a specific limit. So mold should maintain the dimensions, otherwise the whole section is going to change with the dimensions only. So typical sketches of a timber as well as a steel molds are shown in the figure. So the inner side of the mold shall be applied with the suitable part bond release, and it shall be kept for a smooth concrete platform coated with a particular cement powder and finishing it. Alternatively, wrinkle a free odd newspaper may be used to concrete over a concrete platform such that we should not get any wrinkle inside and all things. So reinforcement cage shall be placed inside the mold in which such a way that a provide of a 15 mm cover should be also provided in the particular concreting and reinforcement distances. And RCC planks for well graded aggregate of a maximum size 10 mm shall be poured to the depth such that after compaction with a plate vibrator shall be become a 30 mm. So it should be when it is there 10 mm, so it should get reduced to 30 mm like that. The upper side of a longitudinal members of mold and two tapering shall be placed over a mold. Concrete shall be then poured in a middle and the slides and compacted with a plain plate vibrator. Then the concrete shall be finished level with a mold top surface. Half an hour of about casting, two tapering members may be lifted off, so those tapering members can be removed off. The mold may be stripped off about 2 hours. So depending upon the weather conditions, we can keep it for 24 hours or we can remove the part of molding after 2 hours. Using also the rapid hardening cement, we can make that particular. So about 20 to 30 hours of casting, it should be kept, and the curing shall be placed in the particular position, vertical position, and while transporting also it should be in the particular vertical positions only. So this is the typical sketch of the RCC mold, the steel mold which we can use. So this is the steel mold. So we can see this is the steel particular jack of a 3 mm thickness MS plate and 5 mm thickness plate. So this is the handle which we can easily lift for the particular sections. So MS 10 mm handle is provided at this end, at this end. Then this is the particular grooved type which is handle provided. The handle is here one more, here and more. Then the particular hinges are provided such that it can be easily rotated in this way for the removal. So that first we are removing, then we are closing, then the concrete is filled. So this is the steel mold of a RCC plank. So curing, unit shall be taken stacked against a vertical support nearly vertical position and cured for at least 2 weeks by sprinkling the water, not pouring the water, sprinkling the water. It shall be further air cured for any 2 other weeks more than before it can be used for the constructions. So any design checks can be done also, or test of those particular part can also be easily conducted. Thank you and see you in the next video.